The Shelly Door window sensor detects and reports the opening and closing of doors and windows, tilt angle, vibration, and looks. And guess what? I will integrate this sensor with Home Assistant and Node-RED without any flashing or modifications. What's up, Kirill Pajaskis here. I bought this brand new battery-powered creation from Shelly that supports MQTT protocol out of the box. And MQTT is a widely used protocol in the smart home world for communication between IoT devices. In this video, I will do a quick unboxing. Then I'll pair the Shelly door window sensor with the Shelly mobile application. I'll also disable the cloud connection to enable the MQTT support. And for dessert, I will integrate the Shelly door window sensor with Home Assistant. And I will create an example automation with notification there. For the Node-RED part, I will create a flow that will detect the sensor changes using MQTT nodes. And then again, I will send some kind of notification. Before we go further, I just want to tell you that this video is not sponsored by Shelly, and all that you see here is my honest opinion about the product. You can be the sponsor though, and actually this will cost you nothing more than a few moves and one mouse click to smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm. Now, let's go! This is the box of the sensor. Inside there is a flyer and the two parts of the sensor. This is what the box looks like. Door window sensor, battery life up to 2 years, 2.4 GHz, Wi-Fi, fast response, look detector, web server is embedded, SSL, push notification. Inside the biggest part, you have to insert the batteries. I had some difficulties to find the exact model of the required batteries. Just don't confuse the batteries CR123A with CR23A. They are quite different. It's open from here. This is the reset button. If you hold it for more than 10 seconds, the sensor will be reset to its factory settings. I had some issues to pair this device during the last step of the process, but maybe it's my Wi-Fi to blame. At the end, I made a hotspot from my phone and this actually do the trick. I don't want to repeat the process in front of the camera in order not to confuse you. That's why I recommend to check the user manual and to follow the steps there. Just let me know in the comments if your pairing process went smoothly or you had some issues.
The required batteries. And I will close this.
The batteries are in place and we know the product specification. Now let's continue.
Open your Shelly web interface. You have to find the IP of your device. The best way is to use your router because these settings are not available in the mobile application for the moment. I don't know why. You have to go to Internet and Security menu and then to Advanced Developer Settings, and you have to enable action execution via MQTT.
You will need a MQTT broker to make this sensor to communicate. I can two hands recommend the Mosquito as MQTT broker. You can install it using Home Assistant add-on store or by using the IoT stack as I'm describing in this video.
Here you have to type your username, password and your MQTT broker. You can enable retain or quality of service here. I'll make this to 1 and I'll click save. To make the things even easier with the MQTT, I'll use this tool called MQTT Explorer. It's a free tool, you can Google it. Inside the MQTT connection, I'll type a name, host or IP, port, user and password for my MQTT broker and I'll hit connect. Inside this tool, I'll see all of the available topics. Currently, I don't have anything for Shelly, but I'll open the sensor and I'll close, and immediately the topic is displayed. And these are all of the states of the sensor. As you can see, the current state of the sensor is closed. And if I, let me show you real quick in my camera, if I open the sensor state will change to open. The same is valid for tilt, vibration. If it's zero, there is no vibration. If it's one, there is detected vibration. Lux and battery percentage. This is also not percentage, it's degrees. You can use these values in your automation as well if you wish. And from here, I can use this path as a topic in my home assistant and Node-RED. I will copy this and I will go to my home assistant.
It is time for home assistant. I will create an automation that will send emails when the sensor changes its states. Or in other words, when a door or window is opened or closed.
Open your home assistant and then open the file editor. If you don't have file editor, you can install it from Supervisor and add-on store. Open your configuration.yaml file and search for your sensor section. If you don't have search, add one. In this sensor section, you have to copy these lines to add all of the sensors of the Shelly. Don't try to remember them. You can copy and paste them from the video description. The only thing that you have to change is this ID. You have to replace it with yours. Everything else, you can get it as it is. So paste these lines inside your configuration.yaml and save the file. I already did that. Then go to automations.yaml file. Inside this file, you should paste these lines, and again you can find them in the video description. This is the automation. The trigger is changing the state of this entity. You can specify here from what state to what state. If you uncomment these two lines, this trigger will be only activated when the state of this sensor is going from closed to open. Now, every change is a trigger. The action is sending this text. Someone just take the current state of the sensor, either open or close the front door. So at the end, it will become someone just open or close the front door and use notify Gmail. If you don't have this notification service in your home assistant, you can watch this video that I'm showing right now and you can enable it. Of course, you can change this notification with whatever you wish. Save this file after you paste these lines and then go to configuration. Server controls, check your configuration. If it's green, go to server management and restart your home assistant. I won't restart it because I already add my configuration. After the restart, in order to quickly check if everything is okay, you can go to developer tools, states, and here you can search for Shelly if you see something like that, or if you use the same names as me, you see this. Otherwise, you should type your names here to check if the sensor is available. If you see something similar here, you're good to go.
What sensors are you using for your door and windows in your smart home? Let me know in the comment section below.
Before we test the automation, you can go to the dashboard of the home assistant and you can add cart like this. To do that, you can click on this dot here, then configure UI, the big plus orange button, and here you can search for entities card, click on it, and inside this card you should add all of the sensors that we add in the configuration.yaml, and when you add them you can click save. I already have that card, so I don't need it. Now, in order to test if everything is working, I will open the MQTT Explorer and I will leave the Home Assistant like that, and I'll close the sensor. We have to wait a bit, and if everything is okay, I should receive an email. Okay, the sensor is closed. I hear the ding-dong sound, and if I go to my Gmail, I will have the email from Home Assistant saying someone just closed the front door. Very good!
Let's make Node-RED and Shelly door window sensor the best friends!
Now we can continue with Node-RED. I'll open the Node-RED inside the Home Assistant. I install this as an add-on from add-on store again, and this is the simple flow to test if everything is working. In order to import it, you can use this menu, import, and paste the JSON inside it, and of course you can get this JSON from the video description. I'll quickly explain what this flow is actually doing. This is the first node, MQTT node. Here you have to enter your MQTT server IP. Click on the pencil. Here you have to type your IP of the MQTT broker, the port, the security, and click update, done, whatever it is. This is the topic of the state of the sensor that we want to monitor. You can get this from the MQTT Explorer, if you remember, from here, copy and paste this here. Name, it's optional, you can type whatever you wish here and click done. Next node is very interesting, it's called Report by Exception node, or RPE. It only passes data if something has changed. That means, because this node on regular intervals will push its states towards, if this state is the same, for example, it's always closed, nothing happens. But when this state changes from closed to open or vice versa, this node will pass the message forwards, otherwise it will stay up to this point. This is inject node. I'm using this to manually test the flow. It's optional. If I click on this button, I will simulate the close message. That's usually coming from this MQTT node. Next, this is a simple debug message to show me the event that is coming from this or this node. And this is the call service node from the Home Assistant and Node-RED integration. If you install Node-RED from Home Assistant as an add-on, this is pre-configured for you. You don't have to add a server here, otherwise you have to edit this and add your Home Assistant in order this to work. From here you can choose any domain available in Home Assistant. In my case I'm using Notify domain, and the service will be Telegram. So I'm using service Telegram in my Home Assistant from Node-RED to send a message. If you don't have Telegram service in Home Assistant, watch this video and you enable it in no time. And the final thing is this data which is actually containing the message that I want to send. It's just a simple test, so let's try to test it.
Hey, if you're new here, consider subscribing. Now let's go back.
Currently, the sensor is closed, and I'll open it. And we're going to wait a bit. I'll open the MQTT Explorer. And it's working! Very, very good!
Any sort of engagement on this channel does really help a lot with the YouTube algorithm. So you make sure that you hit the subscribe, like and bell buttons if you enjoyed this video. Also, feel free to add me on Twitter by searching for this username. You can find me on my Discord server as well. I really hope that you find this information useful and you now know how to configure Shelly Door Window Sensor with Home Assistant and Node-RED using MQTT. Thank you for watching, stay safe, stay at home and see you next time!